Torres. Hi and welcome to your reading. How does this person feel about you? This is a timeless and a general love tarot reading. And this reading is meant for everybody, for people in a relationship and for singles that have someone in their mind. I hope you are well, Taurus. Wherever you are in the world, I have been a little bit under the weather. You can probably still hear it in my voice. So I really wish each and every one of you health above all. Now, in this reading, as usual, we are not only going to see how the person that you have in mind feels about you, but also this person's intentions and next steps or actions towards you or in this situation, Taurus. Thank you for stopping by, Coral Twittero, here and now. Let's focus on the energy. Taurus, how does this person feel about Taurus? How does this person feel about Taurus? Please, universe. The lovers. All major arcana. Justice, hermit. Wow, eight of swords. Can you see? We had lovers flipping. So Taurus, pretty bold energies here on the table for you. It feels like someone's, you know, has been internalizing a situation. To me, this is internalizing a situation. The hermit and the eight of swords, big time sort of energy of internalizing this connection between you and your person. It's a very significant connection. It's a soulmate energy. Right next to the justice, you guys I might be talking to people that, you know, are in a, have been in a connection for a long time. And it is marriage. For some of you, you have been married together. And it looks like your person's been growing. The hermit sort of draws my attention here. Your person's been growing to understand the depth of this connection. Okay. I feel they have finally recognized it. They are finally recognizing it. I'm not sure what makes this person feel that they, you know, can't kind of, the Eight of Swords. Share this, we're gonna clarify, but I can see someone that has been growing to understand the depth of a connection, a very possibly even marriage connection for some of you with the justice. So yeah, it's like having an epiphany. I'm getting that your person's kind of finally having that epiphany about this. What connects you? What's between you two? Why is the Eight of Swords? Why does this person feel as if they can't? The Hermit again. The Hermit again. The Hermit clarifying Eight of Swords. It's you could be dealing with a fellow earth sign Virgo, but yes. But I feel it's that epiphany in itself. Causing your person to kind of feel like they don't know what to do with this. Well, celebrate it, I'll put it this way. I feel them, yeah. I am reading energy of someone who's been in a connection for a really long time, possibly, you know, years. Because of the Hermit here twice. And your person has finally grown, you know, they've been growing in this connection, growing up, growing. And also they have been, they finally understand the depth of the connection. Okay, I was shuffling here. This is Eight of Wands. Thinking of clarifying the justice. There is something about communication, love-related communication. The Eight of Wands clarifies this, the justice. So I have a feeling that your person, after years of marriage or relationship, have finally kind of grew to understand the depth of the connection that you guys in, and the thing that connects you, which is the lovers, which is a very significant love connection. Still looking at this, I'm not really focused yet here on intentions. They are finally aware that, you know, what you guys have is what they have been looking for all life, you know, this lantern in the Hermit's card, you know, this little star hidden in the lantern. They've been looking for it all life, and they finally, you know, understand you, the lantern, the connection between you two is the lantern, is the star, is the thing that they have been looking for. Okay, let's focus a bit more on intentions. What are this person's intentions for Taurus? You could be dealing with Virgo or Libra or Gemini. intentions. Please show me intentions of this person. What are their intentions? You know, the hermit to me symbolizes such a long time, and okay, we have a lot of stuff here. I'm just gonna acknowledge the first one. I cannot take all of them, can I? Why not? I can. It told me to take it, and I am. Coming back to hermit, Taurus. To me, this is such an emphasis on, you know, internalizing the connection, growing in this connection, growing to understand what this is. And because it's a hermit, it really could have taken years. That's why I'm talking about that. For some of you, you are in a relationship. Some of you are married to this person, and your person's finally, you know, got it. Okay. But there was something else that I wanted to say with the hermit. We've got here High Priestess, Queen of Pentacles, King of Cups. Beautiful Page of Cups and the Moon. Look, there is a lot of emotions, there is a lot of intuition and a lot of emotions, and some really grounded energy with the Queen of Pentacles. I feel you have got someone who does like a lot of, you know, the Hermit here, together with the High Priestess. Even that King of Cups is giving me all the same sort of vibe of person who does use a lot of their own internal, you know, resources, like intuition and also intellect, but I feel your person with this High Priestess is kind of saying, I'm gonna follow the gut. I have finally figured out, I'm pointing to the Hermit, and I finally figured out, you know, who we are together. This, who we are. And I'm gonna follow the path. I'm gonna follow the hunches that I have here with the High Priestess. You know, the Page of Cups is a beautiful energy here, and I do feel that, you know, your person may finally start showing that love that they have for you, the deep love that they have for you. King of Cups is this symbol of very deep emotion, very deep feelings, often unexpressed. And I feel Hermit is also not very good at expressing, because, you know, this is energy of someone who lives in secluded, you know, lives in its own bubble, let's call it this way, and takes all the time in their life to figure it out, okay? And your person has done that, and, you know, these people may be out of touch, like, so I welcome the Page of Cups, because I'm getting that I feel you are going to be receiving some beautiful gestures of love, of that love that this person has for you, and they do have very deep love for you, very deep love. This is not a person that's gonna disappear or ghost or evaporate or change mind. They've done their thinking and they finally figured it out. You know, the moon to me, again, it's a very deep emotion. This particular deck has got such a beautiful visual aspects that are so easy to decode. Deep feelings, deep emotions that will be finally somehow with the Queen of Pentacles. I'm getting that your person is gonna finally somehow, you'll have tangible expressions of love, and that is everything. That is help, that is support, because that's tangible, you know. This is the way your person is going to be gifting you the love they have for you. I feel in a tangible way. Don't expect big things, I would say, but I am getting, because it's a Pentacle Queen, I would say, you know, everything from, yes, even financial support, but help, like literally help. I don't know, you're gonna walk with some shopping bags and your person's gonna fly there to help you with it. These are very tangible gestures of love. Like literally freaking helping someone, for God's sake. I mean, let's be honest, some people aren't good at it. And others. Ah, okay. You could be dealing with Pisces as well. Taurus, what an energy. So the intention is to finally show you how they feel. How deeply they feel. The intention is to show you in a tangible way, show you how deeply they feel for you. That's what I'm getting. I love that. You are an air sign and you will appreciate that tangible way. I mean, everyone probably would, especially if this is, you know, helping. Being helped, being supported. This is, for God's sake, such a human way as well. Okay, let's see. Now, what are this person's next steps or actions? I think we are ready because... oh, look, yes, we are. I've got this Six of Wands. So they definitely want some... They definitely want things to work out, things to be, to expand. Seven of Pentacles. They have been patient about a new cycle with the world, connecting with a soulmate. And I have taken one more out of. Okay, here we have. I'm noticing that Jupiter here, and Jupiter in astrology is all about expansion and luck, good luck. It's the lucky planet. So I'm getting that this person really wants, even for those of you that are married, have been married to this person for years, they really want this to finally, you know, work out. To expand, they really want to see that they have laid foundations for a huge expansion, growth. I see this as a foundation, these two. Interesting. I see this as foundation of expansion, of further growth. Look, we have the world and the Empress here. They do talk about the same to me. A new phase of expansion. I'm reading it as an energy, and I do feel that that's what it is. A new phase of an abundance and expansion in your life, which I feel really, you know, if someone finally figured out that they are with their soulmate, hooray, you know, it's like, yeah, celebrate it, embrace it and celebrate it and build on it. Seven of Pentacles, I kind of feel that, you know, the Seven of Pentacles here, it's like this residue of the hermit energy of this, I've done so much, I'm putting so much effort, I'm waiting patiently for the results. That's what Seven of Pentacles is. So you might experience that your person might finally start becoming impatient. Because they want to see that growth now, since they figured it out. Yeah, they can't wait for the new phase, I feel. The Seven of Pentacles and the world right next to each other. They can't wait, you know, it's like, I'm putting in so much effort. They can't wait for that new phase, new chapter in your life that the world represents. The Six of Cups, it's a soulmate connection, soulmate card. Yeah, I that's how I feel it. Like, this person's figured out things finally. They really now want to see an expansion. So to me, this is expressing all what was not expressed before. I feel the deep feelings, the love they have for you. I am really, really also drawn to the Queen of Pentacles. I do believe, Taurus, you either are dealing with someone who is another earth sign, perhaps Virgo, or they have prominent Virgo in their chart, maybe if not sun, but rising, ascendant. Ascendant is also a very, so they can have a rising sign in whatever, let's say Libra, Gemini, or Pisces, but maybe, but they have a rising, Virgo rising, and they'll be, yeah, showing you love in a tangible way. I see for the next couple of weeks this person finally showing you what they feel for you, how they feel for you. And like kind of pointing to a direction in a very now kind of focused way. They want expansion, and they feel like, now since I've figured it out, that's the direction for us. And the Jupiter, as I'm saying, I'm very drawn to this today. And that is good luck and expansion. And this is Six of Wands itself, right? That's a success card. Let's move on to the oracle portion of the reading for you, Taurus. That's a beautiful energy here. Just one. I don't have the words to express how I feel. Well, I'm gonna help a bit here if I can be the medium. Yeah, I feel your person. this is it. Like, I really don't know. I don't know how to express, but I finally figured out who we are. Alrighty. Okay. One more. Love chooses you. Beautiful. You know, if you guys are in a relationship and you are asking about your spouse or husband or wife, love chooses you. This is a tarot oracle, so just major arcana, so let's see which one is sort of overarching this one. The world, okay. Yes, it's a new chapter, a new phase. Celebrate it. The world. It says rewards, expansion and destiny. I do feel that Jupiter here and your person is kind of like really, you know, it's like a boat. They are unraveling the sail. Feeling, yes, it's finally, we've got the wind in the sail. That's the direction we are going to expand our life. We are going to build it so in a solid way on love. So we're gonna live our life and we will celebrate the love that we have. Astrology Oracle. Let's see. This one, Sagittarius. Neptune, oh, this one, and I wanted this one, and Scorpio. So you could be dealing in with Sagittarius, the Explorer, or Scorpio. We've got Neptune, mystery. I feel someone was confused. Clairvoyance, spirituality, dreams, subconscious, intuition, depth, vision, dreams, confusion, illusion, spirituality, Pisces as well. Neptune in astrology is, it's this planet that does, you know, it brings spirituality, altruism, and also confusion. I feel this has to do with your person who needed that seriously, almost a lifetime to figure out what they have in front of them, right? The relationship. A first house in astrology is the house of self. Physical appearance, early childhood goals, personality, self-image, identity. I am getting that, you know, there will be changes of self-esteem, essentially, boost of self-esteem for your person, especially, and you too. I feel that once we on the recipient end of love, you know, we glow, okay? It's such a beautiful energy. And I feel that's what I'm getting here, that there's two people that are going to get a boost of confidence from that love that's between them and their partner. I will stop here, Taurus. This was a beautiful reading. If you enjoyed it, Don't forget to like and subscribe, and if this resonates, please do leave some sort of comment in a section with comments. Thank you for your energy, thank you for your time, Taurus. I wish you well, and I'll speak to you soon. Thank you, and goodbye for now.